Okay, let's identify first the root. So Al-Kuttab. So the root is Faris. Can you help us? Kaf and ta and ba. So we get rid of the definite article, the, because commonly the definite article it's not related to the root, and the long vowel, and here I have shadda, so I have already taken only one consonant. So writing, so this is related, the kaf and ta and ba conveys the idea of the writing. So here I have something in relation to the writing. And here can any instructor gives us a brief idea about Al-Kuttab, like in our society, summer. So please.
It's an old way to, an old way of learning. Especially it was started in Upper Egypt, and it's still up till now, they maybe use it in memorizing the Holy Quran and giving some instructions about religious instructions.
Yes. So thank you, Samar. So in the past, the children used to go to this place, and it's called Al-Kuttab, because it gives the children the principles of writing and reading, and also help them to memorize the Noble Quran. And it's in the form of Fu'al, because this pattern conveys the idea that there are like many times, like there are things that are done for many times, or there is a repetition. And here, like in Al-Kuttab, people or the children used to repeat after the grand sheikh, like the grand sheikh says something and the children repeats after him. So Al-Kuttab. So this is, we all of us know, this is in Amaya, it's called
Aish.
And it's root, Al-Jisr min Al-Aish. Al-Jisr. The first consonant is
Ayn.
Yeah. And Sheen. Can you give me any other lexicons in relation to Aish?
Yaish.
Yaish, the verb in present tense, and Naisha, the living, okay, or a standard of living. What else? The verb in past tense?
Aisha.
Aisha. So why Al-Aish has the core meaning of living?
Because we eat it too.
This is like here in Egypt, we eat everything with Aish. Can any Egyptian person here gives us like what does he usually or she usually eat with Aish?
Food
with Aish. Tamayo with Aish.
Gibna
with Aish. Asal with Aish.
Mrabba,
Mulukhiya, and Al-Fatta.
Bamya. Bamya.
Like, so actually, like, this is like, Aish is very important in Egypt. It's like rice, perhaps, in Japan. So, like, it has the core meaning of living. Yeah. So, El Saharati. So, would you please give me the root?
Sin.
So let's do it together. We will get rid of the definite article the. Okay, so the L doesn't exist, and the prefix to M. Okay, and we will get off the long vowel. So the A and E doesn't exist. And ta marbut, or here it's the normal ta, so also we will eliminate it. So we will have the seen and ha and ra. And let's know first what is nasaharati. I will show you. Okay. idea about المسحراتي.
So in Ramadan, we fasting during the morning, so we have suhoor. So this guy wakes us up to have suhoor.
Yes.
Yeah, in a very simple way to the point.
Okay, so this man, and actually he is still like he still exists because in the past people they don't have an alarm. Okay, so this man used to walk before the dawn with his drums, and he tries to wake up the Muslims in order to eat the light meal before they fast. And why we don't have, for example, the like in المسحراتية, the like the female version, like why we have this as a man, not a woman?
So maybe woman is in addiction,
okay, yeah. Very good reason. And also because he walks before, like it, like commonly in the late evening. And like commonly it's not that safe for a woman, and also to leave her kids and her family and just walk in the street to wake up people. So المسحراتي. And this سين and ها and را, it conveys the meaning of the time before the daylight or before the dawn. Okay. We have مزين, and مزين it's an old word, perhaps some old people use it, and we will explore its meaning later on. So yeah, so what is the root of المزين? The first consonant, we will eliminate زمين. So the first consonant is
زمين.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, النون. And this conveys the idea of decoration. And this pattern is the pattern of the active participle, which is the door of the action. So can you guess the meaning? So it means what?
The one who beautifies something.
Or decorate. So it's and now like actually like all people they stick using المزين, but some people say حلاء, and actually now most of the youth say the hair stylist. Hair stylist. Okay, so المزين. So it conveys the idea of decoration because they decorate themselves. Okay, مقشة or مقشة. The root is and very shadda. So when we have like two consonants only in the root after eliminating zameen and the ta marbuta, so perhaps there is shadda. So qaf and sheen and sheen, and this conveys the idea of the straw. Yeah. And this form is the form of or the pattern of a tool commonly. So yeah, this is نقشة or مأشة because it's made of straw. And yes, after the revolution, this word spread a lot, فلول. Okay, and فلول, it's the plural of فل. And the root is فاء and لام and لام. And commonly, people used to say فلول to any member, like to any person who was a member in the National Democratic Party after, before its dissolution. And why? Because this root refers to a scattered group after they, after being defeated. That's why, like, yeah, after the dissolution of this party, we used to say about any member. Like of this party, who was a member at this party, we used to say فلول about them. And the irony also that Muslim Brotherhood, they used to say فلول about any member in this party, and after the party also dissolved, people started to say "flul" also about them. But commonly, this word is like coined with the national party. I don't know if we have time for an activity. Do you think that we have time for a small activity? I don't.
Yes.
Yes, the students are saying, okay, we can have just a small activity. This is one of the recent, actually, topics that are spread through social media. And just I need the instructors to be the facilitators and try first to make the students understand the core meaning of this text.